Hello there, and welcome to Path to Nowhere. Now, this is something I played this a little while back, and I played it a little bit, but I'm discontinuing that series and I'm gonna restart the entire game for you. Because when I was playing it, I realized that this game, I was like, I might play it like for like a couple of episodes and then I'm gonna drop out of this. But then I stopped playing and then I was just in my phone and I was like, let me try it on my own. And then I kept playing and I kept playing and I kept playing and it's just so fucking good. I'm 62 level, by the way. And that's not particularly low. My sinners are also very high level. So I'm gonna teach you everything that I know in this game and obviously show you the entirety of the story. And I will not be showing any combat. I will just eliminate combat because I was watching what I recorded and I uploaded and I was like, there's a bit too much combat and I think I'm wasting time in combat. I think the story is just so much fun that I don't think we need to bother with all this fighting. I will obviously have to do the fights, but I'll just do them on my own, edit them out. By the way, her name is Hecate, apparently. She said it. I always call her Hecate, but apparently it's Hecate. I'm gonna play this city's first level in its completion, and then I will show you every little how do you play this game, actually. And then we'll continue on the story. So let's start with the very basics where the story actually starts. That is one level one. I don't have the energy for that, but hold on, I think I can access that still. Okay, I found it, and this is the entire video file of the entire thing, and I'm gonna be showing you all of it, and I'm gonna be watching these myself as well, and we will just go through the entire story, and I will read it all out as much as the game allows me to read. Obviously, there's some stuff that just is voice acted, and obviously all the fights will be gone. I don't know if I actually have to do the fights with this one myself, because this is just a video log, but maybe I have to, we'll see. Listen to the wind flapping the mirage of the sea. Search for who's flickering the fireworks in the stars.
You're finally awake. How much do you remember? Your name, your face? Do you remember who you are? Can you only remember these? Fate is so cruel. But it doesn't matter. As long as you still remember who you are, you won't lose everything. Come. Come back to me. Your battle has begun. I will wait for you.
Cleanup squad, level one alert. Unknown sinner invading. Unknown sinner invading.
There she is. Last time I didn't know about this little feature. I figured out way too late that I can just remove the HUD, I was about to say HUD HUD from the screen. So we're gonna get some great thumbnails.
You're finally awake. I've been waiting for you this whole time.
Technically speaking, our character died because he was in like a deep sleep and then she woke him up and he doesn't really remember much of anything. So technically the original character is dead. It's like, because the person is a different person. I've discussed this before.
You don't look well. Did you have a nightmare? Tell me, what did you dream about?
Don't listen to her! This is an attack targeted at you!
On one side of the recovery pod, several researchers were squashed into the wall. The only conscious person is shouting at you desperately.
Chief, don't leave the repair pod! If you don't complete the repair program, your mind will be...
The man's face and voice are swallowed by a shapeless darkness. He falls silent.
I don't like being disturbed. Great. Now stand up. We've got a lot to do.
Stay away from him!
The bullets keep coming ceaselessly. With a few grunts, the woman before you collapsed onto you before she even had time to twitch once. A series of rapid footsteps soon burst into the room.
These creatures are still alive. Don't stop shooting. Keep them under control.
That's pretty cool. I think that is Nightingale. Maybe?
Copy.
Chief, can you hear me? Hold on. I'll get you out soon.
Deputy Chief, watch out!
Over you, the body suddenly jerks. Several monsters burst out from under the ground all of a sudden, separating you and the rescuers.
Dead yet? Protect Chief. Team 4, cover. Get away from her, now.
But we're inside the pod. Try to get up. You struggle to get up, but a hand presses you back into the icy liquid. Yacht, look at that. This is the thumbnail I was waiting for. Fuck hell. Now this video is getting views. Whenever I load up a saucy thumbnail, it's just like, oh, views. And this woman, who should have been dead, props herself up. She slowly approaches with a foul smell of blood, trapping you in a narrow space.
Where are you going? It's not over between us yet. I won't give up easily.
What do you want? The woman brushes your cheek with her hand. Her nails scratch your skin, leaving a sting.
I can't take you away now, in this case. This body? You can just give it to me.
That looks pretty cool too. Alright, she has like a copy ability or something. She licks her finger and slowly gets up. The terrifying smile on her face gradually blurs, even her body begins to distort and deform and eventually turn into yours.
Goodbye.
That looks pretty cool as well. I don't actually know why she took over this like form of our character. Like I actually legitimately don't know why she did that. Because she has not shown up in this story as far as I've played, but yeah. She sits on the raised platform and leaves unhurriedly, with your face still on her. A woman in a uniform appears before your sight and carefully holds you up and puts a coat on you.
Sorry I'm late. Are you hurt?
Who are you?
I am Nightingale, your adjutant. The consciousness repair program got disrupted, so your memory is severely damaged. You must be very confused right now, but the intruder stole your bio information just now. She will use this disguise to break through all security systems and cause an even larger riot.
That's what it's for.
You're in extreme danger. Time is running out. Please leave with me now.
Who am I? Sounds more fun.
You are the top authority here. The new chief of Minos Bureau of Crisis Control. Not a moment goes by without those rioters wanting you dead.
You are escorted by guards through the confined corridors under the glaring lights and alarms. A huge guarded area appears before your eyes.
Level 1 alert. Sinners escaped. Alert.
That's another cool thumbnail. Man, that looks so cool. You know what this reminds me of? This reminds me of that one prison from Tokyo Ghoul. I think it shows up in season 3 or something. Yeah, that's what it reminds me. I don't remember the name of the prison, but yeah.
Here we go. This is Minos Bureau of Crisis Control, the jail for the most vicious criminals. Every criminal here is a great threat to the world, and you, Chief, are supposed to be the strongest force to restrain them. But now, an intruder has sparked off a riot. The prisoners are completely out of control. The first thing these rioters will do is...
The tempered glass in front of you suddenly explodes. Nightingale immediately protected you behind her and blocked the few people who bursted out.
Hey, isn't this Adjutant Nightingale? Don't tell me that guy behind you is new. Look at his dumb face. I bet he's still just a loser.
Chief, stand back.
I didn't expect to be free again. I planned to just run away. But since you guys have taken such good care of me, how could I not repay you?
Tell him! We can only be truly free if that man is dead!
So he realized we were the chief, or did he not realize that?
Chief, Adjutant, get behind me!
And that's the first prologue area. I don't know where this continues from, shit. I hope it continues right where I want, because if it doesn't, then I'm going to have to play the chapters themselves. Okay.